Let's talk about the Samsung 1.5-ton DC inverter air conditioner's outdoor PCB today. I'm going to explain how to test it when a fault occurs, where to begin, and which areas could potentially have faults. If the outdoor unit is not working at all, the first thing you should check is the electrical point to ensure that electricity is actually present there. If there is a stable power supply with no fluctuations, the next step is to check the fuse. If the fuse is damaged, there's a high chance the PCB can be repaired quickly. However, I always recommend doing a physical inspection, as this makes it easier to identify the faulty area quickly. If the fault isn't getting resolved, then something close to or within the same circuit might be malfunctioning. Once that component is repaired, the PCB repair will likely be successful. The power supply is installed here. You can see the fuse is installed directly in line with the power input. If we move to the backside, you'll see the fuse located here. There's a connector, and this point connects directly to it. This indicates that the power is going straight into the line filter through this connection. But before that, there are some other components present. Here, you can see there is a ZNR, which is used for overvoltage protection. In this circuit, three ZNRs are installed, and their main function is to protect the PCB from overvoltages. If an overvoltage occurs, the ZNR will short itself and blow the fuse, or it might trip the main breaker. This ensures that the rest of the PCB remains protected and doesn't get damaged. After this, there's a device installed to handle surge voltages. Surge voltages typically last for a very short time, just a few milliseconds. If surge voltages do occur for any reason, this device, along with the two capacitors installed next to it, work together to protect the PCB. Their function is to ground the surge voltages before they can cause damage to the PCB. By grounding these surge voltages, the PCB stays safe. After that, there's a filter installed, which is used to control spikes. Following this, there's the line filter. The function of the line filter is to further clean up any remaining spikes, surge voltages, or fluctuations. It ensures that any disturbances are filtered out, providing stable and clean waves to the rest of the system. After the line filter, there's another capacitor installed, which also serves the purpose of filtering. Moving forward, you can see more capacitors. These two are used for filtering. Essentially, the entire setup is a filtering system. There is a PTC sensor installed here, and the electricity passes through it and goes directly to the PFC module. Now, I'll return to talking about the filtering system. Once the AC is converted to DC, it is smoothed out. This side of the circuit only works for the compressor. Now, regarding the SMPS system, you might wonder where it has gone. After the filtering, a separate supply has been provided for the SMPS system, meaning that it is not connected to the high side of the circuit, but rather has a separate system. There is a ZNR present, which means that AC high voltages are coming in. After these high AC voltages, there's another PTC sensor installed, along with the filtering capacitor. But where is the rectifier? Let me show you. It's located on the back side. You can see a rectifier here on the back, and its purpose is to convert AC into DC. On one side, AC electricity is coming in, and on the other side, DC electricity is coming out. Along with it is a smoothing capacitor. The purpose of this smoothing capacitor is to reduce the ripple in the rectified DC signal, creating a more stable and consistent DC output. Now let me explain what components are installed in this SMPS circuit. If we look closely, the first thing installed here is a filtering capacitor. After that, a few resistors are installed, along with two capacitors and a switching IC. The switching IC used here is numbered top 253PN. Next, you can see another filtering capacitor installed, along with an overvoltage resistor. Following that, two diodes are used, and there's a chopper as well. Additionally, for feedback in this SMPS circuit, an optocoupler is used, along with a reference IC, which is KA431. Apart from these, different voltage levels are present at various points. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.